speak fluently in Spanish, and so I will continue in English, but maybe next year it will be better. I'm very pleased to be here for a moment with you, and I would like to thank all of you in Guadalajara, Cordoba, and especially also in Santiago, Mr. Sergio Martinic, who has introduced to the ORIALC UNESCO book on, let us say, educational systems and the governance of education, which is a very important topic, not only in Latin America, but also in Europe, where the universities are in a period of transition. And I'm very happy that the theme of today is focusing on education and science in a Latin American context, and starting from the point of departure is, of course, the problem of alphabetization. In the meantime, I would like to say that also in Europe, and there is a problem of alphabetization, because alphabetization is not only a question of being able to read and to write, but also of being able to think. And again, on this International Day of UNESCO Day of Philosophy, with a wonderful message by Irina Bokova, I would like to emphasize that in educating, we try to introduce young people in a way of thinking in a very critical way. With the Flemish UNESCO Commission, today we are designing a strategic plan, but not a strategic plan which is very theoretical. And I was very happy when, I think it was Fernando who was referring to working in a very concrete way when we are dealing with education and setting up educational programs. So with the Flemish UNESCO Commission, we are focusing on very concrete actions, actions in which we try to make the government, but also particularly the education, the universities, the high schools, the secondary schools, primary schools, to make them conscious of the importance of learning young people to think in a very critical way, because that's the safest way to the dialogue and to peace building. So again, thank you very much, and thank you also to Patricia here in Leuven, who with her students builds up a wonderful program with video conferencing. And we support that with the Flemish UNESCO Commission, the Flemish government also, but also with the university here in Leuven. And in the 1960s, the 1970s, a colleague of mine, he is now a retired professor and a good friend, Louis Bach, he was a professor of economics. He published a book, The World is Our Village, in 1970-71. But today, with the technological means, the world is really our village. And so I do support this program and thank all of you for participating in a very positive way. And once more, thank you very much also to Sergio Martinic for his collaboration to this conference with the universities in Latin America and here in Belgium in Flanders. Thank you.
Voy a hacer una traducción resumida, si es que hace falta. Profesor Maffer-Bennett desea agradecer a todas las sedes, tanto la participación de UNESCO ORIALC como a las universidades, justamente para contribuir no solamente al tema de la educación, los temas, los desafíos contemporáneos en América Latina como el analfabetismo y también la construcción de las redes tecnológicas, sino también a pensar la educación como el camino para desarrollar el pensamiento reflexivo, es crítico, que es justamente el tema que ocupa hoy al Día Internacional de la Filosofía, como la educación es justamente la vía que nos libera del dogmatismo, que nos permite transitar hacia la libertad. Él nos contaba también que la Comisión Flamenca trata de fomentar justamente el desarrollo de estas reflexiones sobre la educación, que es un tema que ocupa no solamente América Latina, sino también que ocupa Europa. Europa está muy preocupada sobre el destino de la educación. También se piensa que, esto lo agrego yo, la Unión Europea está tratando de crear cierta homogeneización con todo este proceso de Bolonia que está llevando a muchos debates. Es un tema que entonces es muy candente aquí en Europa. Por otro lado, él nos estaba contando que un profesor de los años 70 aquí en Lovaina había escrito un libro que se llamaba El mundo como una aldea, ¿no es cierto? La aldea global, y es justamente lo que estamos ahora vivenciando a partir de las videoconferencias. Entonces, muchísimas gracias a todos. Desde aquí nos despedimos. Quizá medio minuto para todas las sedes para decir adiós y hasta la próxima. También Santiago, si quiere estar la próxima semana, también es bienvenido. Muchas gracias. Hasta luego.